Alright. Final chapter.
Yep.
This is the best chapter.
The best? Really?
It is the best of all game final ending chapters.
Okay, cool.
Chapters. So I guess Isla del Sol is actually in the shape of a sun.
They're all frozen.
And yes, the bloody tower is a rocket. Bowie's in space now.
Appears a bit phallic. I don't know. Hey, that's just me.
Sure, it can be phallic. it's a tower.
Yeah. Kind of like that tower
this gigantic erection of a building
yeah.
is flying up into the sky.
I mean, I would not be surprised. This is a Japanese game, after all. So, gotta.
Oh, maybe you're just too willing to look for like phallic symbols.
I don't know. Maybe they're just trying to please the female audience.
Oh god, it's a tower.
Oh god.
I'm so lightheaded.
Hot. Almost as hot as Jean.
Yeah, Jean is awesome. And yeah, she was brainwashed the entire time, by the way. And she's still alive!
I will survive!
Oh, exciting music.
Oh, this music is the best music in the whole game. I love this track.
I think I've said this before, but the soundtrack is really great to this game.
It is. I was gonna buy it, but it's quite big. It's like 5 discs.
Oh, jeez. You could just download it.
Alright, so some people in the thread may remember I said that I couldn't pure platinum this, but I was wrong. Some guy on YouTube, I can't remember your name right now, it started with a Y, he told me how. Basically, you're gonna mash the button. Now, I totally forgot that the cardinal rule of this game is to mash buttons. But yeah, what's supposed to happen is those rockets that come out there hit you, and you can dodge them to get witch time, and you can get more combo points that way. But no, if you just smash the button, you get fired. I think the combo rank for that is 260, so it's pretty high.
So yeah, when in doubt, mash buttons.
Yes. Also, this is the only time getting witch time with Jean is really easy. Normally, because when you can unlock her as an unplayable character. Playable character. Her witch time is triggered only by getting a perfect evasion, as in, you know, Bayonetta's moth within?
Mm-hmm.
Bat within? She can only trigger witch time using that.
Huh.
So, that kind of sucks. Oh yes, and you'll see that her number plate there, it says 01QTJ.
Which means?
As in, as in 1QTJ, as in John. And yeah, she's driving a freaking motorbike up a tower. Mm-hmm. I don't even know how.
On falling debris.
Who cares?
Yeah.
Who cares? It is awesome. One thing about Jean is that these specific verses make her... you play her more often than Bayonetta because of these verses right here.
Mm-hmm.
Technically.
More quick time.
Also, I have no idea what happens if you miss that QTE. I guess you just fall into space and die.
Yeah. What is that, by the way?
What's what?
The gold
thing. These
people
things?
No,
I don't know where these golden people came from.
No, and the gold tower. Are those rocks or something?
It's a tower of eternal darkness, which is made of people.
Oh, they're people. All right.
Yeah. Or you can put it another way and just say it's a huge tower from the bus.
Yeah.
No.
Oh God.
Please stop talking.
The one and only authentic left eye. Merely seeing it must stir jealousy within you. Your body
must yearn to feel a new universe form around. Go back to being the right eye, please. I have no intention of talking.
Yes.
I am here to reclaim my Umbran sister.
And I will plant my flag in her eye. But
there's an obvious joke I could make here, but I'm not going to because I'm not that vulgar.
Oh.
I am clearly not that vulgar.
Okay.
But yes, he destroyed the moon.
Mm-hmm.
So you gotta wonder how the hell Jean is walking up this tower here, because she's using Witch Walk to do it. And Witch Walk relies on the moon.
Yeah.
Plot hole! Yeah, there are a couple of plot holes in this final stage, but who cares, it's awesome.
Yeah, like, how can she breathe in space?
Yeah, maybe in this universe, space has air.
Yeah. And there is no sound in space. I'll just shut up.
Yeah, that's true. None of this should be like, you shouldn't get a hit.
Yeah, let's just mute this part.
My immersion.
Yeah.
And yes, we are running up the legs of a gigantic woman.
Mm.
Let's not talk about, like, those people with a... what's it called? That tiny fetish? You know, there are people who have fetishes of, like, being with a huge woman.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's just creepy.
Mm-hmm. I think I actually know one of those guys. Really weird.
Oh my god. You know the strangest people.
Mm.
But yes, there is an Alfheim at the beginning of this tower. And we're standing on her boob.
Ha! Oops.
And I think that's America there, but I don't know.
Probably.
I thought they flew out of Europe.
Okay, let's go back and watch. Aww. I can't really tell.
Yeah, it's just like a bunch of cloud. Like, I think that they're...
Yeah, that looks like Florida,
like
I think.
Florida,
yeah.
Or something? I don't know.
It's America.
Final Alfheim is an easy one.
Woo!
So let's talk a little bit more about Jean. You unlock her by getting a platinum or above on normal or higher. Her wicked weaves do 1.5 more damage than Bayonetta, and she also gets 1.5 more damage. She can also evade forever. Oh yeah, she also gets double combo points during Witch Time, which is triggered by using that. And it's really hard. So you can imagine doing Use Witch Time Alfheims with this woman is really hard.
Uh-huh.
See my videos for reference.
So you really have to trigger, like, exactly at the right time.
Exactly every right at the every single time.
Oh,
or you can use the Moon of Mahakala. Blah.
Yeah, that's blah. That's for pussies, I guess.
No, that's an easier way.
Yeah, pussies.
I use it more often, to be honest. Yeah, I'm a pussy.
Don't mind me, I probably can't even finish
also,
this game.
Also, I believe Jean doesn't actually earn... She earns magic a little bit slower than Bayonetta. At least it feels that way to me.
Okay.
She earns it a lot slower.
Would be terrible to play the use torture attacks. Alfheim.
Yeah, basically, you just gotta, like, taunt. Run away and taunt. Mm-hmm. And then block. That's the way you gotta do it.
I hated that Alfheim. I still hate it. I haven't even finished it yet.
Is that the one you got stuck on?
Jeez. I suck.
Is that the one you got stuck on?
Yeah. Still.
Yeah.
Oh well.
Today I spent an hour doing that Alfheim.
Oh.
Only because I wanted to pure platinum it, so yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And then in comparison, I did, like, a defeat all enemies in one shot, so, yeah. And I got 3 million combo points on that one.
Taunts. You missed
them.
Yes,
different taunts. So her long taunt is, I would die before I allow the Umbra to vanish from this world. And, yeah, she's got a bit of a potty mouth on her.
Oh my god. She's been naughty.
You motherfucker.
Hmm.
But yes, I'll post all these descriptions up in the thread, so don't worry about pausing the video if you care about this stuff. And maybe at some point I'll post the accessory descriptions as well, I don't know, just for completeness sake.
Blah blah.
But yeah, she's got her own versions of each all the weapons, mm-hmm. and they've got slightly different descriptions. Oh, and she also gets a special taunt with one of the unlockable weapons,
ooh.
Which I can't show now. Basically, you have to equip the weapon and wear a certain outfit, and when you taunt, she gets a special taunt.
Bitch, please.
Just whip it.
But yeah, basically what I'm doing is preparing for the next chapter.
Mm-hmm.
And here's what I'm talking about infinite evading. It's easy if you hold down Mokon and use a direction and press jump. Yes, that's another way you can dodge. You can hold down Mokon if you like using Mokon, and you can press jump, but if you don't have a direction pulled on the right, on the left stick, she'll jump.
Mm-hmm.
But if you have a direction pulled, she'll dodge in that direction, which is kind of useful, but I've never used it. And yeah, I forgot that taunt there. That's a taunt for the Tonfers. Whatever hers are called.
Mm-hmm.
I suppose I could have cut this out, but I like this music a lot.
Mm-hmm.
The time has come for Jubileus to return. At
last, oh, glorious day!
Yay! Here's one thing I don't get, is why does he want to do this? Like, why does he want to destroy the world and make it over again?
I don't know.
This is not America's Next Top Model. You don't need to remake it over.
Then this thing should have slept for eternity. Now you must wake up, Cereza.
But it's still gonna wake up, right? So
yeah, I think so.
So why did they...
When you reunite the left and right eye, she wakes up.
Oh.
Jubileus wakes up.
Sean.
But now she gouged out one of its eyes, so...
Yes,
story's done.
Blinded.
Game over.
God.
Bye.
And yes, Jean floating away,
no.
Left to die in space.
I've seen Luca die too many times to believe she is really dead.
No. You're not gonna believe me, are you?
No. Not anymore.
No one can control Jubileus now. His power is too intense.
Blah blah blah, dead.
Blah, blah.
See? Dead.
All the struggle! The trinity of realities!
Well, he must really hate himself now.
Why did I do this?
So why did I do this? Ah, damn it.
I'm gone in a blink of an eye.
Ah, damn it. But she's still waking up! How is that possible?
So yes. Jubileus is a woman,
mm-hmm.
and Dea there is Latin for goddess, not god.
Mm-hmm.
I was wrong.
Yeah, who would have thought? God is a woman.
Yes, god, as in the masculine, is just Dea,
mm-hmm.
D-E-I. Thank you, Jesuit education.
Woohoo! Jesuits, F-T-W.
I'm off to get that black cat.
What black cat?
I
don't know what
yeah.
she's saying there. Okay, so this is one of her attacks here. She's got a three-punch combo. And you can get which time with the last punch. And when she does that attack, she says something like, "You'll see," which means bring us forth. Oh yes, and the combo rank for this fight is really high. I'm talking like 84,000. So the only way you can get it is to use kind of weak weapons and don't let your combo break at the beginning. Oh yes, and those flying head things, they're called drones. And they have a couple of attacks, which are kind of annoying because you can't really tell when they attack. But they charge you. But you can stun them pretty easily, and you can also do a panther punt, which is to kick them around. And when you do that, you don't need to press the button, you just need to aim when they go.
Tentacles.
Ah yes, those hair pieces. They say certain things. But I'll talk about it when it actually becomes a bit more relevant.
Second stage.
So here I like to equip Odette, because Odette has fire immunity thing. You can walk on fire. And you'll see that hair piece sort of said something like Bustier, which means glory. In Enochian. Mm-hmm. And for some reason, when you kill all the tentacles, you lose a whole bar of magic. I don't know why, but you do.
Can't you just use torture attacks on the hair pieces or something?
Well, that's the thing, you don't press the button combo to do a torture attack, but you lose the whole 8 orbs of magic for some reason.
That is weird.
So that says something like Komsa or Komma, which means trust you together. Kind of doesn't make sense, but oh yes, if you get caught by any of the ice that's falling around, or that they get shot there, you get frozen in a block of ice, and it sucks. Because what happens after that is that purple tower of light there, it can freeze you again, so it keeps hurting you. You get stuck in this infinite loop of shaking out of, like, being frozen and being killed by those purple towers.
So pretty much it's game over.
So yeah, this one sucks. We've got a flying electric world. And this one kind of sucks too. Tip, change your feet to electric Durga. It actually helps. Okay, those hair pieces, they say Comcel Const. Comcel Const. You can hear it. That means a circle of thunders. But yes, the reason why you have electric Durga on the feet is because they shoot those lightning orbs. And like with the gracious electric attack, you'll be immune to it when you have electric Durga. So yeah. And the only way you can get around is by having that jump QTE. You can't get around by using your panther or the crow. If you do that, you'll get hurt by a tornado.
See, that's really weird, because you could totally make those jumps. Oh well.
Yeah, normally you could, but yeah, you have to use QTE instead. Every time I see this, I think, I really wish I had pulled out the sword and tried to pause my combo that way. But oh well.
And it's gone.
So this is her final stage here, and she gets a couple of new attacks. This is one of them here. You hear this sort of weird, kind of deep, bassy sound. Uh-huh. And she shoots these galaxies at you.
Oh god!
And if those galaxies touch you, you lose a bit of health and you get turned into a little Serazer.
Yay.
And all you can do is walk around.
And she will stomp you to death, I guess.
Well, that's the thing, like, in the final, like, she always follows up with a punch. Like, the punch combo, and by the third punch, you will always turn back into Bayonetta just in the nick of time.
Uh-huh. Oh. Cool.
And here we have a black hole. That's an instant death there, if you get stuck in that.
She is pretty violent for a goddess, you know.
Yeah, I'm not really sure how she creates, or I guess that's a stupid question, she does create landmarks and
she
stuff.
She creates galaxies.
Yeah. Huh. Created like little Milky Ways and everything.
I don't think this was in the Bible.
This attack here is new. It's like an ice storm. If you stay outside the periphery of the hair pieces, you'll be fine. There's also one I didn't get to show off. It's a laser storm. And you get all these lasers following you. It's kind of annoying. But yeah, apart from that, there's not much to say. It's a pretty cool boss fight, I guess.
So if you use regular weapons, like non-Durga, she'll heal, shield, it will die easier?
Yeah, she'll die easier. You notice I'm not using the sword very much because the sword does a lot more damage, and if you do that, you won't get the combo rank.
Okay.
You definitely won't get it. Like, you want to use weak weapons like the pistols or Durga.
If you're interested in combos, I guess. Which I am.
I think my first time doing this, I got something like a silver. It's pretty terrible. Because it's a really high combo rank. Oh. I'm pretty sure if I didn't have Gaze of Despair equipped, it would be a lot lower. Uh-huh.
Silver medal is the lowest, right?
Lowest you can get is stone, actually. I haven't actually shown that off because I'm so pro.
Don't think I've gotten a stone
medal.
But yeah,
stone award. Each award has its own, like, character. Like, the stone award is Enzo, and he says, oh, what a day. And, next one up is a bronze, and you get Serazer. And after that is silver, you get Luca. And, after that is gold, and you get Rodan. And, the thing about the Serazer and Luca ones, like, if you get that award before we're introduced to those characters in the game, they'll be masked.
Oh.
So they'll appear as just regular Lumen Sages.
Uh-huh. It's a nice touch, I guess.
Yeah. They were really touchy about spoilers, apparently, which just kind of doesn't make sense to me.
Uh-huh. I mean, you meet them pretty early on in the game, so.
Yeah, Luca you meet in, like,
chapter 2 or something?
Second chapter, yeah. But yeah, this is the climax bit.
It's like the...
You only have 1 minute to kill her.
The climax of all climaxes.
Yes, you only have a 1 minute time limit. If you miss it, she'll break free of the bonds, and you have to beat her up normally. While this music is going. It's really strange. And yes, it has happened to me before. I had no idea it could happen. God, I almost knocked my laptop off my couch.
What'd you say?
Ava Vogo, Avocado.
Also, my crotch.
Okay, that's summoned there. Yes, you can look up right at her crotch. That summon there, she's summoning someone called Queen Shiva. That summon there means the fallen one of the Moon of Darkness, let her be governed by that in which thunders. And this is Queen Shiva. Shiva is a kingdom mentioned in Jewish scriptures and the Quran.
Oh man.
The actual Queen of Shiva also makes an appearance in the Bible, which describes her as traveling to behold the fame of King Solomon. Mm-hmm. So she was, I guess she wasn't that great a queen.
And I love that just.
But yeah, we just punched a soul out of Jubilee.
Yeah, and the Infiniton and the Big Bang bonus, I just love that.
Yes. Oh yeah, actually the Megaton and Gigaton and Infiniton thing that is apparently a reference to an arcade game.
Okay.
Called Sonic Blastman. But yes, here we are controlling Jubileus and trying to fire her into the sun. Kind of the same as the boulder fight in the previous chapter. And if you hit any of the planets, you get an instant game over.
But who cares about those planets? It's like anyone's living on
them.
Yeah,
no one cares about Mars or whatever.
Neptune.
I mean, we already blew up the moon.
Yeah.
You know?
Which must be creating chaos back on Earth, by the way. Oh well. Oh, there is Earth. Were we near Earth? Actually.
No, we were. When we punched her into the sun, we were near Pluto, which is not a planet anymore, game.
Yeah.
God.
Get your facts straight, game.
But yeah, sometimes I actually find that session really hard. Surprisingly.
Like a boss.
Yeah, so we punched her soul into the sun. I don't even know how that works. What the hell?
It's fucking Shiva. She can do that shit, I guess.
Oh yeah, she does look a bit like Shiva.
Yeah.
But yes, here is what happens when you get hit by a galaxy.
Boink.
There's a smidge of health, and you become Cereza in a black dress. And all you can do is walk. You can't go to your weapons menu or anything. And you saw there that she got turned back into Bayonetta in the last minute.
By Mars or Jupiter, whatever.
I'm pretty sure that was Mars. Cool note, that was on my previous attempt at a pure platinum run.
Huh.
So I had spent a whole hour and a half getting to this stage, and then I crashed into the freaking planet. And I got this.
And you're like, fuck!
What a load of bullshit. Yes, it was a load of bullshit.
Could just reload the last checkpoint?
No, because when you hit the planet, it goes into cutscene mode, mm-hmm. So you can't start, go back to the main menu, try again thing. It'd be really twitchy in that area. But yeah, that's the end of the game.
Yep.
And I guess Jubileus has made it a stone.
Mm-hmm. Hideki Kaima did Devil May Cry, right?
Yes, he did Devil May Cry and Akami. And
oh, man.
Some other stuff.
I haven't played that game. I really should.
We managed to stop this.
I knew it!
Yeah, I
knew it! See?
John, you're alive. She's not even surprised to see Luca alive, but Sean's like, oh my god, John.
Yeah.
And yeah, she was saved by her sentient.
Next thing you know, it'll start talking.
One of a kind. It'll be like cars. Who's going to save the world? I'll send you home, even if it kills me. Now. Cool fact, John has smaller boobs and butts than Bayonetta.
You and I are going home together. John, we're both one of a kind.
She looks really pissed for some reason.
Yeah, I'm not sure why. They look kind of pissed there. It's like, I just have to do that, I have to do this again.
Yeah.
So yes, now we have to break up the body of Jubileus before it hits the Earth.
There's just no end to this. Just fucking goddess.
Also, the movement is incredibly janky here, so if you're not careful, you will break your combo. And the combo here is actually pretty high. I think it's like 13,000, and I just barely make it.
Where is Jean?
She's doing her bit,
yeah.
I guess.
Faffing about. Oh wait, I think I saw her.
No, my combo breaks, fuck you, statue. But yeah, movement here is annoying, so I blame that. There's Jean.
Eh. Shoot bullets at you.
So yeah, I just made the combo rank there, thank god. And then I have to spend another whole 2 hours getting this recording right.
Let's go! Just stay close to me!
Well, that's a familiar scene, isn't it?
Yeah.
Way back in the beginning. I'm just surprised they didn't get burnt up in the atmosphere or whatever when they fell down. You know?
It'll be like, poof! On.
What's going on? My face is too low res to tell.
Also, the moon! Where is it?
Moon!
Okay.
Where's Sailor Moon gonna live now?
How do you keep surviving all this?
Yeah, that's a good question.
I bet you're trying to sneak up on me right now.
Luca, please. Bayonetta. If you want to mac on Bayonetta, please wipe your mouth. Like, we still haven't established what that smear is. You better wipe it off.
Such a shit face. Huh. Well, I guess she didn't survive the ozone layer after all. No rest for the wicked.
But at least she's
back in the box she came from. And I guess I'm gonna have to find a new racket to line my pockets.
No, I think we haven't seen that guy, like, literally since the first chapter.
Yeah, the very first gameplay thing. Yep. They make a deal with the devil. You know, I wonder what kind of world it is where nuns dress like that. You get set down
in the hill and that would be a great world, if nuns looked like that. As well.
It is like obligatory that you have to wear glasses and skin tight suits.
And you have to be hot, because I don't want to see an 80-year-old nun dressed like that. That would
be
terrible.
When you get past like 40, you're not a nun anymore.
You get to wear the robes. Give me your cigar. Like a Bausch.
Does it even work like that? Are there such things as ghosts?
Well, there's angels and demons, so I guess there could be ghosts.
Rosemary doesn't work like that, people. What is wrong with you?
It's a big bush.
It's a big bush of rosemary flowers, and rosemary flowers are tiny. This doesn't work. Rosemary doesn't work like that.
I just never thought the chase would
end like this. I have problems with this.
Oh, you floral kind of person. You.
Yes, I know all about flowers and... Rosemary. Yeah, no, I don't.
No.
I just know Rosemary doesn't look like that.
Might help you on the road ahead.
And it's empty.
Road ahead.
Hey. I think Enzo looks really strange in terms of his proportions.
What the hell are they coming down here to get her for?
Of course they'd come for the prize they've been seeking all along.
Holy shit!
You're a snooty bitch!
Yeah. And how couldn't you have seen that? I mean, he was there like 2 seconds ago.
You're wearing these very distinctive glasses too.
It's kind of like Superman. It's like, oh my god! You put on glasses!
God, you're wearing
who
glasses.
Are you? Ass.
How the hell do you wear a suit that just splits down the sides like that?
Yeah. It's thrillo time.
Will you hurry up? Don't tell me you fell asleep in that thing again.
Again. So this isn't the first time they pulled this thing. You gotta wonder how long it took them to think of this plan. Like, okay, gotta lure some maidens in. What do we do?
Well, I can't blame him. They're women. Oh. Sexist jokes.
I'll let that go for now.
Sexist jokes.
What was shoving me into this filthy old casket? Next time some air holes would be nice. You are worms, I hear. Save the chit chat for later.
This can go two ways. Like, really sexy or very violent. Start lezzing out. Do it. Oh. I guess not.
There's probably a fan out of that somewhere.
Yeah,
I know there is. But please don't anyone post that shit. I don't want to see it.
It's rule 34, right? Yeah.
That's the thing. Camille had, like, big objections to seeing, like, Bayonetta being sexualized. And I was like, what do you expect?
Yeah, jeez. He actually said that?
Yes, he actually had problems with seeing, like, you know, this sexualized content of Bayonetta. This video, you better hurry up and finish. I want to have dinner.
Food. So is Bayonetta actually based on some model? Or just from scratch?
I don't believe so.
Because that would be one hot model.
But she was motion captured by a real person, apparently.
Rosemary equates to remembrance. Suits me now, doesn't it?
Rents with it.
That's more like real rosemary there. Mm.
Let's dance, boys!
I have to think of that editor's song. No, wait, that's Interpol. Interpol, yes.
Rosemary.
Exactly.
Interpol, why are you gonna be such dicks? You make such good music!
Are they dicks? Why are they dicks
these days? Apparently they're real dicks when they play live. But yeah.
And their last album kind of sucked. But oh well.
Did it? I liked it.
Nah, wasn't that great. Not like their first albums.
Oh, yeah. Maybe I just hate music now.
I don't hate music. I just guess I grew up. Nah. So yeah, this is the final ending.
No.
Oh.
You're wrong.
Stop toying with us, Japanese people.
Okay, you have half a minute to kill this boy. You have to, kill her in half a minute.
Just do it.
If you miss that half a minute time limit, then you fail and you don't get a reward for it.
No. Oh, Takuo Yamamoto, you
all these names. Yamamoto.
And
Shinohara.
Kazuaki Shinohara. Yeah. Those guys.
Never mind, there's gameplay coming
or
up.
Or girls. I don't know.
This one's kinda hard actually, because it's with weapons I'm not used to. They don't dodge offset like the guns. Yeah, being like seriously twitchy, because you can't restart this, I'm pretty sure.
You can replay the final boss.
Well, I could replay the entire chapter. That'd be a pain in the butt.
Yeah, no. How terrible would it be if you missed these? So like, a perfect playthrough,
yeah,
and then you missed the last one.
It's ruined the plan.
Fuck!
I'm just kind of wondering what all these T Music Gem Impact is. I don't get what that is. Is it like a company?
I don't know. I guess a publisher or a company, I guess. Roshi. Uchi. Sama.
So, last verse, you're in serious mode, and there is actually an accessory that can put you in this mode all the time. Although when you use it, you can't record it your score in the leaderboards or whatever. Because that would just break the game. But that brace, that accessory is called the Climax Bracelet, and you get it by getting 101 Umbran Tears of Blood. Huh. And what is an Umbran Tear of Blood? Well, it's like those crows, for example. Every time you get a trophy or an achievement, that's also an Umbran Tear of Blood. That's pretty much it. Huh. Like, if you get all the trophies or achievements for this game, as well as get all the crows, you'll get the Climax Bracelet. Ah. But there's another way you can get it. You can get it by cheating. You just go to the phone booths in Chapter 2, and you pay like 2 million halos or something.
Oh.
William Chip Beeman.
Yep.
Is Dutch Hill really a name?
What? Huh?
There's some guy called Dutch Hill. Hill on the sound designers. Helena Noguera.
She remixed the
She sung that really girly version of this song. Fly me. Please don't start singing. Yeah. I've already lost enough viewers as it is.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm just going to try and focus on the words and not on the pole dancing woman in the background because it's kind of awkward. You are all I long for. Great Q&A, Akira Nishikawa. Oh wow, there's a Vietnamese person. Ooh.
Really?
Yes, Thuong Nguyen.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, that's a word that you guys can never say, white people. Nguyen. It's Nguyen. Not Nguyen, Christ sakes.
Nguyen. Yeah, why do you spell it like that? Spell like
it's just
new
not that
yen.
Way. It's like the Smith of the Vietnamese world.
Oh.
And yeah, pretty much everyone's a Nguyen.
Nguyen.
Yes. Nguyen. Well, you can sort of shorten it saying Nguyen, but that's kind of wrong.
You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. Oh, so you can sing? Oh, Jesus.
Well, at least I can sing. Your singing is terrible.
Neener.
Oh, I love this gun motif that they got going on.
So now it's time for extra bonusy time.
Yeah, there's a couple of bonuses I'll show off, but I didn't show them all off because I am lame and I haven't recorded them yet. And yes, Converted by Sega is an important difference between this version, which is the PS3 version, and the 360 version.
Which sucks.
Which means, yes, this one sucks. Finally! Pure Platinum.
Yay!
It's not Mummy, it's you, Sereza.
She doesn't know. I guess. 20 minutes? Jeez, felt a lot longer.
Yeah. Most of it... Actually, what was most of it? Huh. Cutscene? Yeah, I guess I should have shown off the gameplay time, but total gameplay time was about 4 hours 20.
Jesus.
That's not normal. Like, a normal person's first time playing through is probably something more like 5 or 6 hours. Huh. Maybe 7. I think my first time playing was 7 hours. But yeah, you get this cool little collage of things.
Which is sort of like concept art, I guess. Or improved.
It's cool.
Yeah,
well,
whatever.
It's not concept art. Yeah, you know what I mean. It's cool things like at the bottom there, there's like Cereza and Young Jean with their little things, and yeah, it's so cool.
Cool.
And you will see the golem at some point making its hand in a certain pose. That's a reference to something. And yes, for getting platinum and above on everything, we get Jean. And we get handguns, which is a reference to Devil May Cry. They look like ebony and ivory. And for doing all of the Alfines, we get that. I'll show it off later. And now let us sit through this very awkward cutscene.
Okay.
It's like a reward, apparently. Like, you get this when you finish the game the very first time. It's like, what the hell is this?
But only the first time?
Yeah, the first time you play through it. Like, second, like subsequent times, you won't get it.
Watch it. No.
Someone motion captured this. Why?
She still looks pissed for some reason.
Yeah, I'm not really sure why that is. I remember when before Bayonetta came out and they were still looking at the videos that like were coming out before it actually was released. They released a video of Bayonetta dancing and it was exactly like this, but it just looked really awkward. But now, because I'm so used to her really strange proportions, that it just doesn't occur to me as being strange. It's not proper to dance like that, Bayonetta. You a stripper? You're not a stripper.
Yeah, Rodan's like, what?
You can play the game as Jean. When you unlock Jean, you have to actually start a new game, so you don't get any of the stuff you've unlocked with Bayonetta. I got kind of distracted by that arse there for a second. It was just there in my face. But Jean's model is replaced in all the cutscenes, but the voice acting stays Bayonetta's. But unfortunately, you don't get Jean dancing in here.
Aww.
You think they could do that, didn't they? This is pre-rendered. Oh, one thing I didn't get to show off is when you finish the game for the first time and you unlock this thing called the Super Mirror. And what that does is it gives you outfits. So you can change Bayonetta's outfit in the game.
To even more skimpy
so
outfits?
Like, yeah, there's like a couple of ones like a Japanese PE outfit or the nun outfit. Yeah. Oh, you also get like a, kind of like a what's it called? Kimono as well.
Yes, I don't get why they would sexualize Bayonetta. No.
I don't get it either, you know? Just look at her. She's anything but sexy.
Let's take a last look at those legs. Go on forever.
It's okay, you can just play the game and see them again.
That's true. I guess it adds to the replay value or something? No, no, no.
Well,
I just want to see Bayonetta
also,
again.
One thing I didn't show off is when you finish the game the first time, you unlock a gallery full of concept art and models. I haven't recorded it yet, but I will show it off.
So yeah, that is it.
That's a wrap. Bye.
Bye, guys.
Fly me in.